Neurofeedback is exactly what I needed, and I can't believe I waited this long. That's what one of my clients told me today. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh, certified neurofeedback practitioner, brain health coach, and cognitive neuroscientist. This client was dismayed that he waited so long to find out how to use the healing powers of neuroplasticity. And the reason being is he has struggled with anxiety and depression for so long. And finding out that there is a highly effective solution that doesn't do anything negative to you was kind of mind-blowing for him. But at the same time, it made him grieve for the fact that he's finding it now and he has struggled for the last 20 years, trying pharmaceuticals, trying different therapies. Nothing worked for him. So why did neurofeedback work for him? The reason it worked is because those feelings of anxiety and depression, what he called the amped up but low energy feelings, and sometimes the feeling of a wet blanket being on him, those feelings are coming from a dysregulated brain pattern in the brain performance pattern that he's using. Now, yes, that's a mouthful, but it's easy to see on a qEGG brain map. A brain map is the assessment tool that I use when people want to work with me. So the way that it works is it's like taking an x-ray, except for it's totally non-invasive. It doesn't expose you to anything negative. But it allows us to visualize what's going on inside the brain performance pattern. So essentially, we can see how your brain is using electrical energy. We know from scientific studies that a brain that's using too much fast energy, that brain will make a person feel anxious due to chronic stress activation. Now, if you're feeling depressed or low energy, that can be because your brain is stuck in neutral. Sometimes your brain is using the brakes during the day. So there's too much slow processing or too much medium processing, which this is a new phenomena because too much neutral is coming from dopamine dependency from screen time. So a byproduct of the stress and depression and the anxiety and depression that this client has felt in the past has been that he has become dependent on going into the screen, using screen time to offset those feelings of anxiety and depression. So he asked me, how does neurofeedback work? He was super excited upon seeing his brain map, knowing exactly where the anxiety and depression were coming from. But then he wanted to know, I don't get how it can possibly work. And of course, I've heard this so many times before as a certified neurofeedback practitioner. I've heard that it's, you know, I don't get it. How could it possibly work? I know I watch a screen. I know it's enjoyable, but how can it work to rewire my brain? Well, the answer is it's based on something called operant conditioning. Operant conditioning is a learning theory that your brain will learn and will perform better when it's reinforced in the right direction, capitalizing on neuroplasticity, your brain's ability to change itself. Now, I said change, not improve, because your brain can be neuroplastic in either direction, in a positive direction or a negative one. Basically, where it chases down the reward and reinforcement, it will follow. So this client had been rewarding his brain with high levels of dopamine from the screen, but he doesn't want to do that anymore. So instead, now he's going to reinforce and use the new healthier brain pattern by using neurofeedback. The way that it works is every time you do a session, and they can all be done at home now, you use a brain training headband in a very specialized app that only providers can use. And in that app, I've set the neurofeedback system to do exactly what his brain needs: reduce stress and anxiety, reduce dopamine dependency, and increase the speeds for calm focus. So when he does a session, what will happen is he will reinforce using calm focus and will not reinforce using dopamine or stress. The way that it works is he can watch a streaming service. You can watch any show that you want. And then when you're watching, and if your brain is hitting the markers that I've set, the screen will play bright and the audio will play loud, reinforcement of the positive brain performance pattern. If your brain goes out of that mode, what happens is now the screen goes dim and the audio goes low. Lack of reinforcement. So the idea is it's called neurofeedback. Feedback from your brain on its own performance pattern so it will make more of the healthy performance pattern. And the best part is it's scientifically proven to work to regulate a dysregulated brain pattern. That's why on the map, if there is dysregulation, neurofeedback can help to regulate that dysfunction so you feel and perform better. That's the magic of neurofeedback. And that's why people have regrets that they haven't found it sooner and they haven't utilized it, because it capitalizes on neuroplasticity, your brain's ability to change itself, improve itself if you're doing what you need to do to move it towards the healthier brain performance pattern. Now, one of the most phenomenal aspects of neurofeedback in the way that I offer it is that there's a plethora of data. We're always showing you what your brain is doing on any given day, charts and graphs that you can see with your own eyes. And then as your brain improves, you can see it in progress visualization. So not only do you feel it, you see quantitative measurable data showing you you're moving in the right direction. So this client was kind of grieving today, saying, you know, I wish I would have found this 20 years ago. I wasted all that time. I was in a downward spiral. Now he's in an upward spiral, which is literally a neuroscience phenomena. Again, it is what's called a positive feedback loop, positive upward spiral, because a flywheel of improved brain performance is shown to happen through science. When you enter into a neurofeedback program, you have improvement and your brain will keep that improvement going. So if you're interested in more information about neurofeedback, and if you feel stuck in anxiety, depression, or any brain dysregulation, and you've tried many things and they have not worked for you, I encourage you at least to get a qEGG brain map. It will show you if you have brain dysregulation, if so, how much, in what areas, and what type. We know from science that trauma, anxiety, depression, ADHD, autoimmune disorders, internet addictions, there's many mental and physical health issues that can be visualized on a brain map. All neurodevelopmental challenges like learning disorders, dyslexia, speech and language problems, occupational and physical therapy issues, they can be visualized on a qEGG brain map. On the other side of the spectrum, neurodegenerative disorders. We know Parkinson's, ALS, dementia, Alzheimer's, they can be visualized on a brain map. So if you're interested, go over to drtrishleigh.com, because I would love to show you how your brain is performing and what it needs to perform better. Then you're armed with the knowledge and the empowerment to be able to make an amazing decision to regulate your brain so you can feel and perform better forever. So go over to drtrishleigh.com for more information. And as always, control your brain or it'll control you.